Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is part 3 in a 3-part series on creating a custom logo animation. Now, in part 1, we animated an image and used text animators to animate our text. In part 2, we created an advanced reflection using compound blur, fractal noise, and some fancy pre-comping. If you haven't seen those episodes, I highly recommend you do that now or after you watch this tutorial. In this episode, we'll be adding some finishing touches to get our final logo animation. And these techniques can be used in much more than just logo animations. In fact, you can take the tools you've learned in each part of this series and apply them to your own projects to get customized, professional results in your animations. This episode is sponsored by the good folks over at AE Juice. Check them out today by following the link in the description below to get amazing savings, as well as AE assets that are 100% free. Now, if you're a serious motion graphic designer, you'll be super happy you found AE Juice. I highly recommend the I Want It All bundle, which gives you access to everything that they offer. So check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Trust me, you won't regret it. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know if this tutorial helped you out. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the amazing deals from AE Juice, and the project files for this series are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. I've created a logo animation for 7-Minute AE Tutorials, so at this point you should be using the one I created or your own. We also added in that floor reflection. If you haven't done that step, which was last week's tutorial in part 2, you can either go back and check that out to add that in, or you can just follow along with me now without the reflection. Personally, I think it looks much better to have that floor reflection in here, but what you'll be learning in this episode can be used in other projects that could use some finishing touches. Okay, so now we just need to add in the final touches, so go back to Project, and let's drag this main pre-comp into a new composition. Command-K to bring up our settings, and we'll call this Final Animation. Hit Return. And so now we can start adding in some color and things like that to really make this thing pop. So let's go up to Layer, New, Solid. Just call this Background. It doesn't matter what color it is. Drag it underneath. And we're going to go up to Effect, Generate, Gradient Ramp. I'm going to make my bottom color like a dark blue, like almost black actually. And okay, then make your top color. You just take this eyedropper and click on that dark blue to make it a lighter blue. So something kind of like that. Let's make this linear ramp a radial ramp. We want to move the start of the ramp over to the corner, and maybe the end of ramp, we want to move it up just so we kind of have a slight light over here on the right-hand side. Okay, and maybe even make that a little bit darker. Just want a slight light right there. Okay, and then I'm going to add in a new solid. And again, doesn't matter what color it is. And we'll say color 1, hit return. And make sure this is above your background layer, but below your main pre-comp. Let's go to Effect, Generate, Fill. And we can leave this at red. Okay, and now let's change our mode. Our track mode defaults to normal. We'll change that to screen. Hit T for opacity. And let's maybe change this down to about 15%. Grab our pen tool, and I'm just going to cut this in half. So that way it's this kind of a shape where it only covers the left half of our comp, but in this triangular kind of shape here. Hit F for feather, and let's maybe crank that up to, we'll say 150 pixels, or actually maybe more than that. We'll just really turn this up high so it blends, and see how the feathering is coming in on the top. If we just kind of pull that out, it'll take care of that. Bring up our opacity again, maybe even like 10%, something just very, very slight. Now let's duplicate this color 1. I'm going to pull this mask down here so that way it's kind of more focused on the floor. So this kind of a shape here. And maybe we can even change this color from a red to something like, you know, light blue or maybe like a green. And we can even bring up that opacity just to kind of give it kind of a mixing of these colors. Okay, and then I want to add in a few more touches. So go up to Layer, New, and we want to add in an adjustment layer. And I'm just going to duplicate this 2 times. We're going to use all of these. So 1, 2 to get 3 adjustment layers, and then also a new solid. to make sure that this is black. And we're going to call the solid vignette. And we'll just go down one at a time and make these adjustments. So with vignette highlighted, let's get our shape layer tool set to ellipse tool and just double click, and it puts in an ellipse for us automatically. Open up our mask settings and just change add to subtract. We'll change our feathering, we'll say to 250, and our opacity to 65. So now we can just kind of grab this and pull it in just to kind of give like a slight vignette, and see if we turn this off and on, you can see the difference. So just kind of has a soft vignette around this. For this first adjustment layer, I'm going to make this a blur layer. With blur highlighted, go up to effect, blur and sharpen, and we want to add in a fast box blur, repeat edges, and then we want to make our blur radius, we'll say 10 pixels. Now let's take our mask from our vignette, command C, go to our blur, command V. So it's the same exact settings. And one of the things I like to do whenever I have a vignette and a blur, you can actually take this mask path and parent it to your vignette and your mask feather, and parent it to your vignette. So now whatever changes I make to this mask on the vignette, the blur will follow. If I make these changes right here, we go back and click on blur, we can see that it copied it exactly. So vignette, watch if I pull these out to the side more, click on blur, the mask is identical. So that's one way to make sure that your vignette and your blur settings are the same. Go down to this next adjustment layer, and we'll call this CC for color correction. Go to effect, color correction, we're going to add in a curves, and I'm just going to kind of add a slight contrast to this. So just kind of bump up the brightness and kind of pull down the contrast. And again, you can see the difference. I think it kind of pops a little bit better. And for this last adjustment layer, I'm going to call this flare. With flare highlighted, let's go to our effects and presets and just type in lens flare and double click on lens flare. And now let's just move this center point over to the corner. And I'm going to choose 105 millimeter prime. I'm going to make the brightness say like 125. And I actually want to put an expression on this flare brightness. So option click on flare brightness. If you type in wiggle 1, 10, it's going to make that flare kind of flicker. So I'm going to solo the flare with the background. If it's soloed by itself, you can't even see the flare. So I've got the flare and the background soloed. And if you just kind of play it, you can kind of see how it kind of has that pulsing effect like that. Click on main pre-comp and we'll go back to the beginning and just go to effect, generate CC light sweep. Okay, and for these settings, we want to change this to smooth, width 60, intensity 60, leave the edge intensity and thickness the same. And remember, our animation goes for 5 seconds. So let's go to the 5 second mark. Let's go to the center setting for light sweep and move it all the way to the right. So see, you can see it right here, how it's interacting all the way to the right, and put a keyframe for center. If hit U on that layer, it brings up our keyframe right here. And we want it to start right as it comes in. So the animation should end at the 20th frame. So now take this center value for CC light sweep, move it all the way over to the left. About like that. Highlight both those keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. I'm just going to loop that area and we can watch it play back. So this is the final effect we get and looks pretty cool. And you can always change the way that this animates in by adjusting your camera settings or your floor settings. You can drop whatever logo you want in there. And let me give you an example of what I mean by that. Let's back into our logo animation. Okay, so let's go in here to AE Juice. Now, this is one of my sponsors, and these packs are absolutely free, so make sure you check them out in the description below. They actually have a lot of really cool free presets you can use. So just click on this starter pack right here. And this Motion Cafe, they have these really cool HUD elements. I'm going to go down here and maybe grab something like this, and you can just drag this in, pull this over to the beginning of our timeline here. And let's just turn off this logo one here. Now remember, we set up our rulers to know where the top and bottom of this logo animation would be. So let's just bring up our scale and kind of increase this a little bit. Just make sure the main one is your bottom position. You want to make sure that you don't go below that bottom position here. So we get something like that. Now if we go back out to our main pre-comp, we can see that it updates automatically. I'm actually going to set this to quarter quality so that way it plays a little bit quicker. So you can set in whatever logo you want and it will update automatically. You still get the light sweep and all of the other settings. That's why in this logo animation here, I pre-comp my logo one. And so you can even pre-comp this, go to layer pre-compose and call this logo two. That way you can toggle between these really quickly, you know, and maybe even add in something else. You can try a different one. And again, you want to make sure that you're within these guides right here. Let's go back to our final animation. Let's lock that down, and then we can go back into our logo animation. Pull that over next to our final one. As we toggle this off and on, it updates automatically. So you can drop in any logo that you want, and that is how you make a really cool logo animation with some cool finishing touches and that advanced reflection using compound blur. I hope this series taught you something, and maybe you can use some of these tricks in your next project. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this episode. Hopefully you learned something new and useful. If you haven't seen the first two episodes in this series, I highly encourage you to do that right now. You can apply the tips, tricks, and shortcuts you've learned throughout this series to any number of other projects. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the amazing deals from AE Juice, and the project files for this entire three-part series are all in the description below. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.